So in February 1st, 2016, the World Health Organization declared the Zika crisis an emergency. And 4 months later, 61 countries and territories had reported cases of Zika. To put that into context, in 2017, only 50 people in total were affected by the Zika virus. The Zika virus is a mosquito-borne disease that causes severe birth defects, such as microcephaly. Microcephaly is where the fetus's brain does not develop normally, resulting in an abnormally small brain and like cognitive deficits, poor motor skills, seizures, and even death. So why am I telling you about this scary CBS News kind of stuff? And how does that pertain to research being done here at Delaware? Well, I work in a neuroimmunology lab that deals with the immune system of the brain, specifically in juveniles and neonates. So I work on a rat model of the Zika virus in the neonatal rat brain. And yes, before you ask, I do work directly with the virus. And yes, I have told my mom. And yes, she thinks it's a terrible idea. So rather than inject the virus directly into a living organism, I instead isolate brain cells from rats and then look at the virus effect separately from the body. And this keeps the periphery immune system from doing different things and altering what I'm looking at. So I'm looking at specifically the proteins that these brain cells secrete upon infection with the Zika virus. Ultimately, our goal from this project is to help characterize the Zika virus and help combat the progression of this disease throughout the world. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Jennifer. Well done.